the old times, the Chepino Valley was the bottom of a lake which was surrounded by dense forests. People inhabited the summits of the mountain. In that lake lived a giant, fearsome dragon which we call Zmei, and it wouldn't let the villagers from the nearby village have water unless they give it a sacrifice. Every year, Zmei had to eat the most beautiful meat in the village. In order to have fresh water, the villagers kept sacrificing maidens from their village. There was a young, beautiful, fair-haired maiden called Velichka, whose turn it was to be sacrificed. She couldn't take the thought of it, so she ran away in the forest. Her beloved was Mitchu, the shepherd. They were deeply in love with each other, so they could hardly be separated. The lad couldn't resist losing his loved one, so he thought of a plan how to not get her sacrificed and defeat the Zmei. As Mitchu was walking in the deep forest looking for her, he spotted something that was stuck in a tree branch. Velichka's napkin had tangled in the branches. After he found the napkin, he eventually found Velichka crying in the woods. He hugged her and wiped her tears away and kissed her. Mitchu gave Velichka a bag of tinder and told her to throw it into the Zmei's mold and lit it and it would explode. Velichka made her way into the crystal blue lake when suddenly it started shaking and then a fine snake protruded from the bottom of the lake. It opened its maw and swallowed the girl. When the snake ate the maiden, she lit the tinder so the snake would explode from the inside. The enraged monster was burning inside, and in its attempt to take a breath, the shepherd grabbed his beloved girl and took her out. It swung its tail and cleaved the mountain in two parts, and from the depths of the lake it began to spray mineral water. In that moment, the lake flowed through the cracks, carrying the snake with it and left behind only an empty basin. At the end, what was left of the snake got carried away by the river, and the villagers celebrated the young couple's return, and they all lived happily ever after.